So here we are again, talking about the conflict between the classes. So, what the fake news won't tell you about the Australia Navy dancers twerking fiasco down under. Well, the whole story revolves around a mainstream media corporate manipulators who were editing the footage of some very bad dancers twerking in front of Navy brass, again, down under in Australia, at the launching of a Navy ship. Now, this story hits home in all the Anglo countries. But before we get to the meat and potatoes of this juicy baby back rib story, I mean, the internet is on fire with this. They're talking the Navy in rear, anchors, well, hey, in the overweight saga, twerks away. I mean, for starters, hot pants are for hot girls, not cows. I mean, come on now. So apparently ABC, the so-called news, or more recently fake news, well, they played around with the editing time frames. I'm not exactly sure what people are accusing ABC of, but basically they're trying to say, the critics are saying that these girls were not actually twerking when the main head honcho came to see the launching of the boat. Now, we're down in Sydney, Australia, with this story at the launching of a $2 billion Navy supply ship. Now, apparently the budget did not include money for any real dancers. So here we are, an awkward international embarrassment of epic proportions. And no, I'm not talking about the size of those hot pants. So once again, this story hits home in all the Anglo countries, that's for sure, because there is a major conflict between the conquering English Anglos who conquered all these former colonies and the underclass of workers who were imported into these Anglo countries to do the menial labor. Now, this conflict here has been brewing for some time now. It surely escalated about the time that Obama and the witch Hillary ascended to power, and they started replacing all the Anglos in government with the lower classes and, you know, Obama and Hillary type friends. Remember, this is what mainstream media won't tell you. That's why we have these conversations, because they will not have these conversations, so we have to. So again, let's get back to history here. As the peasant class started to rise in government, they brought with them the traditions of the hood, where rap music and twerking is all the rage. But quite frankly, the typical average English-speaking Anglo is repulsed by twerking. The Anglo just doesn't see any redeeming qualities in twerking, as the faces of the Navy brass show when you see the video. Anyhow, so when I spoke of government prior, this also includes high officials in the military. Now, Obama managed to replace many, many Anglo senior military officials with friends of his. So again, not to beat a dead kangaroo here, this conflict between the former middle class and the lower ghetto class is real, and it appears to be growing and spreading thanks to mainstream media, fake news / corporate fascism and propaganda campaigns that portray the ruling Anglos as evil. So let's get down to brass tacks here. This story is going viral simply because you have some very bad dancers here, some of which are overweight, performing hideous, disgusting dance moves at a very inappropriate time, broad daylight, at a Navy ship's christening launching. These dance moves are more at home in an after-hours block party in Harlem. Okay, I mean, whoever hired these creatures for the Navy should be fired, and I think that pretty much wraps it up. Ships ahoy!